Welcome to this video. In the previous video, we saw an interesting example based on the method of finding the mode of grouped data. Today in this video, we will see the common mistakes made while solving questions based on the method of finding the mode of grouped data. The following data represent the number of telephone calls in a government office in 2 days, that is 48 hours. So, can you tell what will be the value of the mode of the following data? Pause the video to solve the question and then check your answer. Let's discuss option 2. We know that to find the mode, we first need to choose the maximum frequency of the data. So, from the given data, we can tell that the maximum frequency here will be 13, whose modal class is from 14 to 17, where 14 is the lower limit of the modal class. From the above table, we can see that the size of each class interval is same. Therefore, the size of class interval will be 3. Since we have to find the value of the mode, therefore, with the help of the given data, substituting the values of L, H, F0, F1 and F2 in the modal formula and on solving it. The value of mode obtained is approximately 15.09. So, option 2 is the correct answer. If you have selected option 1, it is a good try. But this answer is wrong. Because instead of the highest frequency, you choose the midpoint of the frequencies. And on the basis of that, have started to solve the question. Upon solving which, the value of mode is obtained as 12, which is the wrong answer. If you have selected option 3, then it is also a good try. But this is the wrong answer. Because in the modal formula, instead of L plus F1 minus F0 upon 2 times F1 minus F0 minus F2 multiplied by H, you substitute L plus F1 minus F0 upon 2 times F0 minus F1 minus F2 multiplied by H and solve on the same basis, which upon being solved, gives the value of mode as 2. Which is an incorrect answer because the value of mode is any value inside the modal class. So hopefully you must have understood why the second option is correct in this example and why the remaining options are incorrect. Teachers can also test students' understanding in class with the help of some such examples.